Good morning, good morning. Oh, this is it's a little murky. All right, good morning, everyone. I'm so happy to be in front of you this morning. I thank everyone for joining. I know it's only been a couple seconds that we've been live, so I'll give it a moment or so and allow folks to join in. I don't know why that's like that. But anyway, come on in, say good morning. I'm so happy to be here with you. We've had a couple people join us in the last week while I've been off. Last week and the week leading up to me going to Aruba with my husband and my family. And so first of all, welcome to the newer people. This is a place where you will be fed the things of God in order to build his kingdom, but also build your life to build his kingdom. And so that's what we're doing in here. And today I'm so super excited, and I'm hoping that the masses actually catch this video because I know something about you, and I want to talk about that this morning. I want to get the devotional ready, but come on in. Just waiting for folks to come in, sip a little coffee. It's Thursday. It's been a whirlwind for me. We left here last Wednesday, and it's like, oh, week is gone, and what do I do? But it's all good. The peace of God, right? So I am going to go down here, look in the comments. Make sure I'm tracking the comments. Actually, let me get a welcome message up to everyone. Welcome to the room. I love it. Welcome to the room. So come on in. All right. So we've waited some time. Let's get into why we are here. You will hear me say, let's get at it. So let's get at it. I know something about you. Here's what I know. I know, and you hear people say things like this, you know, you may have heard people say things like that, this, or you may be one of the people who have not had people speak into their life, so maybe you haven't heard it. But either way, I don't want you to hear what I'm about to say as familiar or as hype. I want you to hear as declaration and as fact. I know something about you. What I know about you is that you are a leader over kingdoms and nations. The word says in Jeremiah that you are a leader. I have appointed to you, when he's talking to Jeremiah, says, I appointed you to be a leader of kingdom and nations. I know you are a leader amongst leaders. In your space, this could be in your job, this could be in your community, in your family, wherever you are the leader. You are the leader. It may be in a certain aspect of where you are. It may be at a certain level of where you are, but you are a leader in that space. And the reason I know that is because I know the voice of our Father. And I know that he has called me to be a leader of leaders. And so it is no mistake or happenstance that you are here listening to me. You are here to be equipped, to be unveiled, to be, when I say it unveiled, just then I could see like layers, like petals coming off of this bulb coming through. You have come here to be unveiled, to be the leader that you are designed to be. We all know, and if you don't, this is where you will learn that God created each one of us for us, because he created you for a specific purpose. He created you, wrote all the days of your life onto a book before you ever showed up. And here is where you really began to meet him on the page, the current page of the book that he's written about you. Here is where you began to have your mindset shifted and elevated to better understand, to not say you don't have understanding, but we all can use better understanding of who God is and who he's created us to be. The word also says that we get understanding and revelation to know him better. Here's where you come to get focused and centered on the things you need to be focused and centered on in order to, let's talk practical, build the brand and bank account that you want, all for the building of the kingdom that he desires. And so this is where you come to do that. And that is who you are. You are a leader. You are a leader. You are not built to be mediocre. You are not built to be complacent. You are not built to be average. You are an above average, right quadrant of a bell curve, supernatural, exponential, work in excellence, leader, trendsetter, ingenuous ideas, creative concepts, innovator, pioneer, leader. That's who you are. That's what I know about you. That's what I know about you. So I wanted to come and be clear with you in case you're wondering, well, what is it? You are here to lead. Now, we may have to do some work on figuring out the people group you lead, unearthing the skills and talents that God has designed you with, on what are those characteristics that will best help you lead, make you be the most efficient and effective leader. We may need to know the assignments, right? We know the purpose. We may need to know the assignments for where you are leading, but there is no question that you are it. Yeah, that you are it, that you are it. You are the leader. You are not waiting for someone else to come tell you you're the leader. I'm coming to tell you today to be clear about it, that you are the leader. And because I know that I know the voice of my Father. I know that you are a leader because I'm called to be a leader of leaders. I'm not called to just make average people do average stuff. I know that about myself. I'm confident about who I am. I know that about myself. If you are under the realm of my voice or even an inkling of my influence, you have been called to do great and amazing things. Because I know God has called me to be a leader of leaders and help them do great and amazing things. So I know that about you because I know it about me. Yeah. And so I think this is right now being recorded in Daily Devotionals with Delilah, which happens on Facebook, which is a very small, it's about 140 folks, intimate group that I talk to often. But I'm going to release this everywhere. Because I people need to know this. I am going to release it everywhere. But I'm also going to leave in Daily Devotions with Delilah the five things that are going to help you get better revelation of who God is, and then subsequently better revelation of who you are and how you can move next. These five things are coming straight out of our devotional, and that's why this video is being premiered in Daily Devotions with Delilah, because it's out of our devotional. I haven't even read them yet. I'll tell you a couple things. I haven't read them in the days. You guys know our daily devotional talks about, gives different devotions for every day. I haven't read them, and they were for the devotionals last week. But when I opened up the book, I knew that whatever is in here for 5 days, it gives an acrostic for the word shape, S-H-A-P-E. It gives an acrostic for the word shape. I knew when I just glimpsed at it that the people need this, and this is going to help those leaders unearth the petals coming off so the bowl can come out, unearth the gifts and talents that are in them. And so what I am encouraging you to do What I'm encouraging you to do is to read the devotionals, right? Read the devotionals. Now, I think what I'm going to do, I don't know how I'm going to play this because there are five of them. And I don't want you to take this as, oh, I need to catch up, so let me just read to read. No, 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 no. This is life-changing information. I know it. I feel it in my bones that this is life-changing information in here for the leaders that are out there. In order for you to get access, you will have to come over to Facebook. If you Delilah's Downloads, Daily Downloads, Daily Devotions with Delilah, y'all already got it because y'all are here. This is where it's really happening. If you are seeing this on Instagram, if you're seeing this on YouTube, if you are seeing this on some other platform, you're going to have to come over to Facebook, find Daily Devotions with Delilah, and find these nuggets. You're going to have to, because these folks at Daily Devotions with Delilah, they rock with me, and this is just where you're going to have to come from. But I don't want you to go through it for the sake of going through it, just to read through it. I want you to take the time and immerse yourself into what God is, what Holy Spirit is sharing with you through this acrostic. And so for you that may be, you know, read one in the morning, read one because they're five, one in the morning, one in the afternoon, one in the morning, one in the afternoon, and one on another day, one in the morning, one in the afternoon, one in the evening, one a day, because I need you to get this. I don't even know what's in it. I know what's in it, but I don't know how it's going to be communicated. I know what's in it is life-changing information and knowledge and wisdom. The application. Give instruction of how to apply the information and wisdom that's embedded in these 5 days. So you approach it. My point is, you approach it how you want to approach it. But take your time and sit in and have a notebook and pen handy. Be ready to hear from Holy Spirit on what the S means to you, what the H means to you, what the A means to you, what the P means to you, what the E means to you. Be ready to action it. This, I just picked the book up. I'm telling you, I was like, you know, we just got back from Aruba. I was sitting down, I was having some good time with God, had some great time in prayer this morning. And I'm like, where's my devotional? Because I left it in my office. And so I went to get it, I opened it up. And when I got to today, it was the fifth day of shape. And as I read just day five, I didn't even read the whole day five. I read, let me tell you what I read. Shape. And then you know how it opens with scripture. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, Romans 12:2, New Living Translation. I read the first sentence. The letter E stands for experience. And I put the book down. No, I didn't put the book down. Letter E stands for experience. And I went back and I saw, oh, this is a part five or four. The people need to know this. I just put a book there. People need to know this. People need to know this. So I'm coming to you to give you the gift that God has stored up for you here in this devotional. I am the vessel. And I love being the vessel because as I allow it to come through me, the residue of what's coming to you, I get some of it. Yeah, I love that about God. I love that about God. As you're doing your assignment and your purpose, you will be blessed. Right? The Ark of the Covenant. Obed-Edom. Right? He had the Ark of the Covenant in his house and he was blessed exponentially, expeditiously, a lot and quickly. And so as this is coming through you, coming through me to you, I also get blessed by it, but you are the best. You are a milestone in the process because as it's coming to you through me, I'm getting blessed to give it to you. But as you activate it and go through others, not only do you receive the blessing that came through me, you receive the residue as you become the vessel. Become the vessel. This is who you are. You are great. You are dope. You are a leader of leaders. You are chain breakers. You are great and mighty high. You are sons and daughters of the Most High God. You are the solution that the world needs. It is you. It is you. And this morning, this afternoon, evening, whenever you listen to this video, I want you to unmistakably know that it is you. There's no question about it. You tried to duck this thing. You tried to hide from it. It's you. It's you. And it's time to get big. Get big on the inside. Confident. assured of who you are, of the gifts, the talents, the assignments. So it's no longer so confusing. Because confusion causes delay. Clarity causes momentum. And so as you get clear, you'll start to see what you've already seen. You start to see what you are. Shout out to my sister Tanya. You'll start to see what you've already seen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So I'm going to drop these five devotionals and daily devotions with Delilah on Facebook. Find it, Daily Devotions with Delilah. Come back on this video, share with God what God is revealing to you, what Holy Spirit is saying to you, or not. I really want you to do this for you and the people assigned, associated with you, your family, your community, your teams, those associated. I want you to do this for you and them. I would love to hear about it just because I love to hear about the goodness and glory of God. But this is really about you and moving, getting big. It's time to get big. 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 I mean, you are gigantic. It's time to walk into that fullness and get big. Okay? Right. I'm going to get into the devotional. I'm going to start this morning on day one. And I encourage you not to delay. All right, I'll talk to you guys soon. Again, you can find the five references that I'm talking about on my Facebook page, Daily Devotions with Delilah. It's not my Delilah Bartlett page. It's not Delilah's Downloads. It is an intimate, exclusive group that you can request to join in order to get access to the information that I'm talking about. Daily Devotions with Delilah. Facebook is the platform. That's where you can find it. You will not find it anywhere else. I'm going to go do that. All right. I love you guys. I'll talk to you soon. Let me know how I can be of help, because I am available to you in this platform. And of course, you know, through other resources and tools and things that I do. Okay. All right. I'll talk to you guys soon. Love you. Take care.